Fibromyalgia? Welcome to Fibro Pulse. I'm Linda. So, what is fibromyalgia? We've got fibro for fibrous tissue, my for muscles, and algia for pain. So basically, pain all over. To be a little more precise, it is a disorder characterized by widespread musculoskeletal pain, accompanied by fatigue, sleep, memory, and mood issues. Researchers believe fibromyalgia amplifies painful sensations by affecting the way your brain processes pain signals. Estimates of the number of people affected are 3 to 6% of the population worldwide. In the US alone, that's 4 to 12 million people. So what causes this condition? Well, that's a bit complicated. In many cases, symptoms begin after some sort of stress, such as a physical trauma, surgery, or an infection. But for others, there's no clear triggering incident. Symptoms seem to develop gradually over time. However it's first identified, the underlying mechanism that causes fibromyalgia is still a mystery. So if the cause is not known, who's at risk for developing this condition? The number one risk factor is being female. Among fibromyalgia sufferers, some estimates show that up to 90% of them are women. Family history is another risk factor. Current research indicates that there is a genetic component to fibromyalgia, though it is not passed directly from parents to children. According to the Mayo Clinic, the odds of developing fibromyalgia are several times higher in the immediate families of people with the condition. Other disorders with overlapping symptoms, such as osteoarthritis or lupus, are the last major risk factor. Diagnosis of fibro is complicated, and getting a definitive diagnosis can be difficult to obtain. A classic test is the tender point exam, in which pressure is applied to 18 specific points on the patient's body. Fibro is a possibility if 11 or more of those points are particularly tender. Other conditions with similar symptoms are ruled out by a variety of blood tests. Though there is no cure, fibromyalgia can be managed through a combination of medications, therapies, and lifestyle changes. Medications can help with pain reduction and make sleeping easier. Antidepressants and anti-seizure medications are sometimes prescribed as well. The list of possible therapies is endless and includes everything from physical therapy to acupuncture. What works for someone might not work for someone else, and even that can change over time as symptoms evolve. Proper diet and exercise are critical for anyone's health, but are extra important for people with fibro. Well, that's a sweeping overview of this mysterious condition known as fibromyalgia. It's a lot to take in, but don't worry. I'm going to expand on these points and more in other Fibro Pulse videos. Thanks for watching. Remember to subscribe, like, and share. Follow us on social media, then come join the community at FibroPulse.com.